In this video tutorial, we're going to look at using a program called iMazing to access data inside your OnSong app if you can't get into the OnSong app for any reason. For instance, you may have a broken screen or the OnSong app is not functional. In this case, you can use this program to get your data safely off your device. First, start by downloading and installing iMazing. Open a web browser and type in iMazing.com. Next, find the download link in the header and click. iMazing is available for both PC and Mac. Choose your platform and wait for the download to complete. iMazing is completely free and does have upgrades for more features. Once completed, find the downloaded file and double-click to install. On a Mac, this is as simple as agreeing to the end user license agreement and then dragging the iMazing application into your applications folder. Once complete, locate it in your applications and then open. Next, connect your iPad to your computer using the USB cable that's supplied with your iPad. You'll see that the status changes to connected via USB. Next, we're going to change preferences in the application to allow us to access data inside the app. Go to the iMazing menu and choose Preferences. In the Storage tab, place a check mark next to each of the options and close System Preferences. Next, click on Apps and then locate OnSong. This is actually giving us a view into the OnSong application. Folders include Documents, Library, and some other files and folders that we don't need to worry about right now. Documents contains everything that's inside of file sharing, but the library contains your OnSong library. Here we can click into OnSong and default and see the contents of our library. What we're going to want to do is click on OnSong under the library folder. Next, click on Copy to Mac or Copy to PC depending on what you're running. Choose a location and then click on the Choose button. The folder will be copied. Now let's switch over to the Finder or Windows Explorer to take a look at what's been copied. Since this is an OnSong library, it contains a database file and may also contain external files that you've imported. Let's select everything inside the default folder, right-click, and choose to compress those items. Again, these steps may be slightly different on a PC. Now, let's rename this file to make it an OnSong backup. The important part here is to use the .backup extension. Now we can take this file and restore it into another version of OnSong by importing it. I hope this video tutorial has shown you some ways that you can recover your data in the event of emergency. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at support@onsongapp.com. Thanks for watching.